We have already studied that sender tap full wave rectifier circuit. Okay, now we are going to study full wave bridge rectifier circuit. In sender tap rectifier circuit, you can see here we have used the two diodes D1 and D2, and a sender tapped transformer is used here. The sender tapped transformer means it has three output terminals from the secondary winding, and the current flow is through when we apply the positive half cycle of AC sinusoidal waveform, then the diode D1 become forward biased and the current flow is through D1 and through RL and upper half of the secondary winding. Similarly, when negative half cycle comes, this V become positive, that means the current flow is through D2, RL and lower half of the secondary winding. So in all time there is output, that is in both half cycle, both positive and negative half cycle will give output current, and that current flow direction will be same in through the RL in both positive and negative half cycle. So there are some disadvantages in using sender tapped full wave rectifier circuit. Here we know that here we are using sender tap transformer, so it is expensive because in the output terminal there are output terminals which is there is an exceptional case which is not a normal transformer. Here there should need three output terminals, so a sender tapping is required in the secondary winding, so it is an expensive, that is a disadvantage. And the DC output is smaller as each diode utilizes only one half of the transformer secondary voltage. At a time only one half of the secondary voltage is utilized for getting current through load resistor, so the output is small, and the diode used must have high peak inverse voltage. It is 2 Vm is the peak inverse voltage. I'll just remind you what is peak inverse voltage. We know that it is a maximum reverse voltage that a diode can withstand without destroying the junction. Alle nammal oru diode forward biased aavuna condition le, at the simultaneous time the other one is reverse biased, so it has to withstand a maximum voltage coming from this hole of the secondary winding, because it is parallel with the secondary winding at a time, and the reverse voltage coming across the reversed diode is become the maximum value becomes 2 Vm. So that diode which should be selected in the sender tap rectifier should have peak inverse voltage 2 Vm. So nammal peak inverse voltage high ulla diodes venam oru sender tap rectifier construct cheyyumbo use cheyan. Idum oru disadvantage aanu. So these are eliminated by using full wave bridge rectifier. So the next one is full wave bridge rectifier. Okay, so this is the bridge rectifier circuit. The need for a sender tap transformer is eliminated here. Here we are using normal transformer only having two terminals from the secondary winding, so the need for a sender tap transformer is eliminated in the bridge rectifier, and it contains, you can see, diode D1, D2, D3 and D4, four diodes, and which is connected to form a bridge circuit. And the AC supply to be rectified, you can see the AC supply to be rectified is applied to this circuit, bridge circuit, to by diagonally opposite ends, to the diagonally opposite ends lottana nammal connect cheyyunnu. That is the voltage, AC voltage is applied to the bridge circuit in the diagonally opposite ends. Okay, and between the other two ends, you can see other two ends are grounded, means these two points are same, that means between other two points, this A and B, your load resistor is connected. Load resistor is here marked as RL. You can see it is in effect, it is connected across A and B. Okay. So in effect you are this load resistor which will be connected like this. This is RL, that means the load resistor RL is connected in between A and B. രണ്ടും ഗ്രൗണ്ടഡ് മീൻസ് ഒരേ പോയിന്റിലാണ് ഈ രണ്ട് പോയിന്റ് കാണിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് ഈ ഒരു സെക്ഷൻ ഇങ്ങനെ കണക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നതിന് പകരം ഡയറക്റ്റ് എ ബിക്ക് അക്രോസ് ആണ് കണക്ട് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇങ്ങനെയാണ് അതൊരു ഇൻഎഫക്റ്റീവ്ലി സർക്യൂട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ഡയഗണലി ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് എൻഡ്സിൽ ത്രൂ ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമറിന് ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഇൻപുട്ട് എ സി വോൾട്ടേജ് അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ആൻഡ് യുവർ ലോഡ് റെസിസ്റ്റർ ഇസ് കണക്ടഡ് അക്രോസ് അതർ ഓപ്പോസിറ്റ് എൻഡ്സ് ഓഫ് ദ ബ്രിഡ്ജ് സർക്യൂട്ട്. Now we are going to consider the positive half cycle of your input waveform. So just consider this positive half cycle. During positive half cycle of secondary voltage, the end P become positive, this side become positive and Q become negative. Okay, when positive half cycle coming across the secondary winding, the end P become positive and Q become negative. So this makes the diode. Which diode will be forward biased? A positive voltage is coming here, and when it passes through here, diode D1 is forward biased, and through diode D1, this D2 will be reverse biased condition. So current will not flow here. The whole of the current will flow through your load resistor, and to diode D2 is also forward biased because it is connected in the same direction. So the positive voltage coming across D3. So D3 is also forward biased. So your current flow is like this: D1, RL, and through D3. So during positive half cycle, the diode D1 and D3 become forward biased. At the same time, D2 and D4 will not conduct because it is reverse biased. Therefore, only diode D1 and D3 conduct. These two diodes will be in series through the load resistor RL. So the current flows from A to B through R. Okay, I'll again shown that. So your load resistor, you just imagine this load resistor is here. This is your RL. So what will be here? It is positive, and here it is negative during positive half cycle. Only positive half cycle is considering here. So when the current flowing through it is in this direction, okay. So current flow is through diode D1, RL, and D3. Ingeniyana current flow vera. Now just consider your negative half cycle. So during negative half cycle, what happens? During negative half cycle, P become negative and Q become positive. Okay. So during negative half cycle, the end P is negative. That means diode D1 is reverse biased, and similarly D3 is reverse biased. At the same time, here Q, the end Q is positive, means diode D2 become forward biased. So your current flow is through diode D2 and through RL, and D4 is also forward biased. So your current flow direction through RL is same. During positive half cycle also it is flowing through this direction, and here negative half cycle current flow direction will be from A to B. So therefore the output is obtained across load resistor RL in the same direction at a time. That means here you can see during positive half cycle you will get the output through D1 and D3. And during negative half cycle, you will get output through diodes D2 and D4. At the same time, other opposite diodes become reverse biased. And here D1, D3 are forward biased. So you will get output for both positive and negative half cycle. So output is more efficient than your output in half-way rectifier circuit. Now we have already considered a peak inverse voltage in a center tapped rectifier. So what will be the peak inverse voltage in a full wave bridge rectifier? Here you can see at a time the peak inverse voltage of each diode is equal to the maximum secondary voltage in the transformer. So here you can see what will be your at a forward biased condition time, the diode D1 and D3, both diodes are connected in series with the load resistance. at a time two diodes D2 and D4. These are coming like this. D2 and D4 will be coming in series and which is in parallel with your supply voltage. It's a AC sinusoidal voltage. So at a time, two diodes will be forward biased, simultaneously two diodes will be in the reverse biased mode. Alle, ore samayathe rendu diodes forward biased aayirikkum, mattu rendu diodes reverse biased aayirikkum. Pakshe aa reverse biased diodes nu parna thammil series aayirikkum, but nammada supply voltage nu adu parallel aayittanu connected aayirunnu. Appo total maximum voltage ee series diodes ne cross varum. So at a time during positive half cycle, two reverse biased diodes are D2 and D4, and the secondary of the transformer are which is in parallel with that diode. So the peak inverse voltage of each diode is equal to the maximum voltage coming across the secondary winding. Similarly, during the next half cycle, you know that the negative half cycle varumbo D1 D3 reverse bias down. So at the same time also the maximum reverse voltage that can be coming across D1 and D3 will be Vm. Maximum voltage nu parayna Vm aayittana irukku. Ivada nammal center tapped idonnum illa, appo total Vm naanu nammada maximum voltage varunathu. So what will be your peak inverse voltage? Peak inverse voltage in full wave bridge rectifier circuit it is only Vm. Because ഇവിടെ ടാപ്പിംഗ് ഒന്നും ഇല്ല, ടോട്ടൽ മാക്സിമം വോൾട്ടേജ് അതിലൂടെ എത്രയാണോ വരുന്നത് അത്രയാണ് ഒരു ഡയോഡ് വിത്ത്സ്റ്റാൻഡ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് Vm. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ഫുൾ വേ റെക്ടിഫയർ സർക്യൂട്ട്സ്. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ട് ആൻഡ് നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ ഇസ് ഫുൾ വേ ബ്രിഡ്ജ് റെക്ടിഫയർ സർക്യൂട്ട്. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് വിൽ ബി ദ അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഫുൾ വേ ബ്രിഡ്ജ് റെക്ടിഫയർ? ഇവിടെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയൊരു ഡിഫറൻറ്റ് നിങ്ങൾ ഡിഫറൻസ് കാണുന്നത് എന്താണ്? മെയിൻ ആയിട്ട് സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് കമ്പയർ ചെയ്യുക. സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു കണ്ടീഷൻ ഇവിടെ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് നോർമൽ ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ ആണ്. സോ ദ നീഡ് ഫോർ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ ഇസ് എലിമിനേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ഫുൾ വേവ് ബ്രിഡ്ജ് റെക്ടിഫയർ. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ആൻ അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജ്. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് വിൽ ബി ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ? ഹിയർ ദ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഇസ് ട്വൈസ് ആസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ട്. ബിക്കോസ് ഇൻ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ട്, സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ടിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കാണാം അറ്റ് എ ടൈം half of the secondary winding is utilized, but in full wave circuit the whole of the secondary voltage is coming across your forward biased diodes. രണ്ട് ഡയോഡ്സ് ഫോർവേഡ് ബയാസ്ഡ് ആവുന്ന സമയത്ത് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് സെക്കൻഡറി വോൾട്ടേജും അതിന് അക്രോസ് വരുന്നുണ്ട്. സോ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് വിൽ ബി ഹയർ ദാൻ ദ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ട്. സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ടിൽ നമ്മൾ ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ദ സെക്കൻഡറി വോൾട്ടേജ് അറ്റ് എ ടൈം യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നുള്ളൂ. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ലോ ആയിരിക്കും. ബട്ട് ഹിയർ ദാറ്റ് പ്രോബ്ലം ഇസ് എലിമിനേറ്റഡ്. സോ ദർ ഇസ് മോർ എഫിഷ്യന്റ് ഫുൾ വേ ബ്രിഡ്ജ് റെക്ടിഫയർ ഇസ് മോർ എഫിഷ്യന്റ് ദാൻ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് റെക്ടിഫയർ. എഫിഷ്യന്റ് എന്നല്ല, അതിന്റെ എഫക്റ്റീവ് ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഹൈ ആയിരിക്കും. ബിക്കോസ് ഇൻപുട്ട് ഹൈ ആണ്, അതുകൊണ്ട് ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഹൈ ആയിരിക്കും. ദെൻ പീക്ക് ഇൻവേഴ്സ് വോൾട്ടേജ് ഇസ് ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് സർക്യൂട്ട്. സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ ഉള്ളതിൽ പീക്ക് ഇൻവേഴ്സ് വോൾട്ടേജ് 2 Vm ആയിട്ടാണ് വരിക. പക്ഷെ ഇവിടെ നോർമൽ ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ ആണ് നമ്മൾ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, അതുകൊണ്ട് ടോട്ടൽ മാക്സിമം വോൾട്ടേജ് Vm വരുള്ളൂ. അപ്പോൾ പീക്ക് ഇൻവേഴ്സ് വോൾട്ടേജ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നതും Vm, അതായത് ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ദ സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമറിനെ വരുള്ളൂ. സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജസ്. മെയിൻ ആയിട്ട് 3 അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജസ് ആണുള്ളത്. നീഡ് ഓഫ് സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ ഇസ് എലിമിനേറ്റഡ്. ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഇസ് ട്വൈസ് ദാറ്റ് ഓഫ് സെൻട്രൽ ടാപ്പ് ട്രാൻസ്ഫോമർ. Sorry, center tap rectifier, and peak inverse voltage is half that of the center tap rectifier. And what will be the disadvantages of a full wave bridge rectifier? Here also you can see the output has some pulsations. Alle correct namaku pose oru AC wave nanna ingane oru straight wave form aanu vendathu, avashya adu ettittilla. Appo there is also pulsation, that is an disadvantage. So we need filters to improve the efficiency of our output. And what is another disadvantage? Because here we uses 4 diodes, alle 4 diodes use cheyyunnundu. So that the voltage drop is also there. So as during each half cycle of AC input, 2 diodes will conduct and which are in series. Therefore voltage drop in the internal resistance of the rectifier circuit will be twice as in the center tap circuit. Center tap circuit la ninga kaano only one diode at a time verunnullo condition appo oru drop alle oru forward resistance verunnullo pakshe ivide varumba rendu diodes series aayittu varunnunde so drop korchude koodale bridge circuit laana because number of diodes are higher in the bridge circuit. Now we are going to study efficiency of full way rectifier. So efficiency, we have already derived the efficiency of half way rectifier circuit. At that time we have considered the input voltage. Let us assume your input voltage is okay. Let V is equal to Vm sin theta. V is equal to Vm sin theta is your sinusoidal voltage. V is equal to Vm sin theta is the AC voltage to be rectified, and you can see here small Rf. This is internal resistance of, that means forward resistance of your diode, and RL, you can see the load resistor RL is denoted as RL. Load resistance value on RL na denote cheynathu. ഒരു ഡയോഡിന്റെ ഫോർവേഡ് റെസിസ്റ്റൻസ് ആണ് Rf എന്ന് ഡിനോട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഒരു ഇൻസ്റ്റന്റേനിയസ് വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് കറന്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് എന്തായിരിക്കും? ഇവിടെ ഇൻസ്റ്റന്റേനിയസ് വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് കറന്റ് വിൽ ബി I is equal to V by R എന്ന ഇക്വേഷൻ എടുക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ I is equal to V ന്റെ ഇക്വേഷൻ നമുക്കറിയാം Vm sin theta divided by total resistance, internal resistance of diode plus load resistance, that is Rf plus R. This will be the value of instantaneous value of current. I is equal to Vm sin theta divided by Rf plus Rl. Okay. That is the current, instantaneous current. And the output current is pulsating direct current. You can see here the output current is a pulsating one. Okay. Pulsating current is output. So this output current will have some AC component within it. So we have to find out the average current to get the DC current. We are going to find out your efficiency. Efficiency equation endana? Efficiency nu parnale output divided by input alle varunde. Ivide nammude output nu parayunnathu DC current aanu. Input nu parayunnathu AC aanu alle. So aadhyam nammal output aanu kandupidikkunnu. Output kandupidikkanengi namukarya nammude output il pulsating output aayathukondu we have to find out the average. So we have already derived the half wave rectifier circuit. For half of the sinusoidal voltage, what will be the average value of current? I average you have find out, that is Im by pi ennu namukku kittittundu alle. In a half wave rectifier there is only output during positive half cycle. During negative half cycle there is no output. So we have already just find out the average of positive half cycle alone. So your average value of current for half wave is Im by pi. Here you know that for both positive and negative half cycle you will get output. So what will be your average value of current? It will be 2 into this value. Half wave node 2 multiply cheyda pole. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മൾ ഓൾറെഡി ഡിറൈവ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട് ഐ ഡി സി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഐ എം ബൈ പൈ ആണെന്ന് ഹാഫ് ഇയർ റെക്ടിഫയർ അല്ലെ. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് കഴിഞ്ഞ ക്ലാസ്സിൽ ഡിറൈവ് ചെയ്ത് നോക്കാം. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് ഓൾറെഡി അറിയാം ആവറേജ് വാല്യൂ ഓഫ് കറന്റ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഐ എം ബൈ പൈ ആണ് ഫോർ എ ഹാഫ് സൈക്കിൾ. അവിടെ ഹാഫ് സൈക്കിളിലെ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നുള്ളൂ ഹാഫ് ഇയർ റെക്ടിഫയറിൽ. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മൾ ഹാഫ് സൈക്കിളിൽ നിന്നുള്ള ആവറേജ് ആണ് കണ്ടുപിടിച്ചത്. സീറോ ടു പൈ ആണ് നമ്മൾ ഇന്റഗ്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്തത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് നമുക്കറിയാം ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ദ സൈക്കിളിനെ നമ്മൾ കണ്ടിട്ടുള്ളൂ. പക്ഷെ ഫുൾ സൈക്കിളിന് ഇവിടെ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് ഉള്ളതുകൊണ്ട് നമുക്ക് സീറോ ടു ടു പൈ വേണം ഇന്റഗ്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ. അപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടുക 2 ഐ എം ബൈ പൈ എന്നാണ്. സോ യുവർ ഡി സി കറന്റ് വാല്യൂ ഇസ് 2 ഐ എം ബൈ പൈ. ഡി സി കറന്റ് അറിയാമെങ്കിൽ യു ക്യാൻ ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് ഡി സി പവർ ഐ സ്ക്വയർ ആർ ഇക്വേഷനിൽ സബ്സ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യുക, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഐ ഡി സി സ്ക്വയർ ഇൻ ടു ആർ എൽ. സോ സബ്സ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂട്ട് ദിസ് വാല്യൂ ഇൻ ദിസ് ഇക്വേഷൻ 2 ഐ എം ബൈ പൈ ദ ഹോൾ സ്ക്വയർ ഇൻ ടു ആർ എൽ. Now AC input power, you have to find out AC input power to get the efficiency. So find out AC input power. For that you have to know the AC current, IRMS value. Normally AC is represented in root mean square value. We already derived that For a half wave circuit, it is Irms is Im by 2. But in full wave sinusoidal waveform, that is Im by root 2. Irms is Im by root 2. So the RMS value of current is Im by root 2. So you can find out the AC power. PAC is equal to, substitute this value in this equation, I square IRMS is Im by root 2 the whole square and RF plus RL. So full wave rectifier rectification efficiency is efficiency as output by input. Output is DC power, input is AC power. So substitute these two equations. You have already find out this equation is your input. And here you got this one is your output. Substitute these two equations here in efficiency equation. So you will, by simplifying this equation, you will get 0.812 RL by RF plus RL. Okay. But IM cancel the boy. Baki unna out at 8 by pi square RL by RF plus RL. So simplify it is 0.812 nu as in percentage, it is maximum efficiency. That is, this RF is term negligible as compared to RL. If RF is far less than RL, forward resistance of diode is far less than your load resistance, this term will be neglected. This term in denominator becomes 1. So, the maximum efficiency of a full wave rectifier, that is, rectifier, if it is center tap or bridge rectifier, the maximum efficiency will be 81.2%. Okay, so this is your maximum efficiency. We have already studied that half-wave rectifier circuit have a maximum efficiency as 40.6% only. It is below 50%, but here you can see the maximum efficiency is 81.2%. So that is, the efficiency is higher as compared to half a rectifier circuit. Okay. Next one is the term which is used here is ripple factor. So what will be ripple factor? The output of a rectifier consists of both AC and DC components. You know that. Actually, AC component is a sinusoidal voltage. DC component is a theoretically DC component. Practically, we have to DC. It should be a constant value. But what will be your full wave rectifier output? Full wave or half wave? If it is half wave, it is only one half cycle on positive half cycle alone. If it is a full wave, your output is like this. Both the output is not like a constant wave. So that means it consists of an AC component within it. Output DC ananda parayan pattilla. Rectifier the function nu vanna, it should convert AC into DC. But here both the rectifiers, if it is half wave or full wave, there will be a pulsation in it. What is the reason for that pulsation? Because it contains the AC component in the output. The output of the rectifier consists of both DC and AC component, and the AC component which is known as ripple. E ripple nu parayunnathu unwanted AC component niyana nammal ripple nu parayunnu. So the component which is undesirable or unwanted component which is present in the output of a rectifier is known as ripple. Okay, so ripple factor means it's the ratio of RMS value of AC component present in the output divided by DC component present in the rectifier output. So you can see the ripple factor is the ratio of RMS value of AC component to value of DC component. That is, you can represent it as IAC by IDC. This is your ripple factor. Then actually what will be the value for ripple factor for half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier? Let us see. So just consider the value of total load current. Total load current ennu parayunnathu endayirikkum, output current ennu parayunnathu. So we already studied that the output of rectifier contains two components, that is AC and DC. So total load current is the sum of magnitude of AC component plus DC component. So you can represent the IRMS value of your output, DC output, is equal to root of IDC square plus IAC square. Both the components are present in your both half wave or full wave rectifier. So from this, you just find out that what is the ripple, IAC. IAC you can write the equation as root of IRMS, this IRMS square minus IDC square. Just divide IAC by I throughout this equation, divide by IDC. IAC by IDC is ripple factor. Ripple factor is the equation we derive. AC component is the AC component equation throughout DC, IDC. Divide. So IAC by IDC is equal to 1 by IDC root of IRMS square minus IDC square. So you know that IAC by DC is the ripple factor. So find out the ripple factor. Just EI 1 by IDC in your equation. IRMS by IDC in the means this 1 by IDC just to loaded. Root and only loaded. So IRMS by IDC the whole square. IDC by IDC whole square. 1 number. Equation simplify. So we know the RMS value of current and DC component of current for half a rectifier. For half a rectifier, RMS value of current is Im by 2 and DC current is derived as Im by pi. Namke rendu value are just to substitute equation Im by 2 Im by pi in all other. So you will get this equation. Ripple factor is equal to Im by 2 divided by Im by pi the whole square minus 1. So you will get the value as 1.21. That is the value, you can see it is 1.211 is greater than 1. So AC component exceeds the DC component. Okay. IAC, ripple factor equation and the, that is ratio of AC component divided by DC component. If the numerator is greater, then only it will get higher value. So the AC component exceeds the DC component in the output of half a rectifier. So this results in greater pulsation in the output. Therefore, half a rectifier is ineffective for conversion of AC into DC. So you know that for half a rectifier, the more filtration is needed because the pulsation is higher. AC component than DC component in a half a rectifier will go. So we cannot use it as a rectifier circuit. So generally, full wave rectifier is used as rectifier circuit. So next, for full wave rectifier circuit, let us see what will be the ripple factor. For full wave rectification, you can see RMS value is equal to Im by root 2, the current value, RMS value of current. And for DC current, you have derived it as 2 Im by pi. So substitute this in ripple factor equation. IRMS by IDC the whole square minus 1. So you will get by cancelling this Im, you will, by simplifying this root equation, you will get it is 0.48. So 0.48 means it is less than 1. That means the output of a full wave rectifier, the DC component is more than the AC component. Numerator less I, and the AC component is less. Effective AC component is less as compared to your denominator, that is DC component. That means AC component less means the rectifier is more effective. Rectifier and the function and then a rectifier more DC and produce and therefore AC component is very koravan and the rectifier effective. So for this reason, full wave rectifier is used as a rectifier circuit commercially. That is, for the conversion of AC into DC, we use full wave rectifier because its ripple factor is 0.48. Okay. So let us compare both half wave and full wave rectifier circuit. So we have studied half wave circuit, full wave sender tap circuit and also full wave bridge rectifier circuit. You know that for a full half wave circuit, it produces only output at the positive half cycle alone. Negative half cycle, there is no output. But in both sender tap and bridge rectifier, there is output for both positive and negative half cycle. And number of diodes used is only one diode is used in half wave sender tap. It is used two diodes, and for bridge circuit it uses four diodes. And the transformer necessary. If it is necessary for half wave, it is not necessary. But for sender tap, it is necessary, and we need the special type of transformer, that is sender tap transformer. An extra tapping is required. And in bridge circuit, we are using transformer, but it is not necessary. And maximum efficiency for half wave rectifier is 40.6, and for sender tap and full wave it is 81.2%. Note down this values, it is important, and also ripple factor value also you should study. For half wave it is 1.21, and sender tap and full wave bridge rectifier circuit it is 0.48. That is more effective the circuit. And output frequency, you can see here the output is available only at one half cycle. So the frequency is same as your input waveform, because the input waveform starts, the next cycle starts from here. So the same frequency. But here you can see the wave has two times the output for a one cycle. That means the frequency of full wave circuit is double the frequency of input waveform. And the peak inverse voltage is V, maximum voltage Vm for half wave. But for sender tap it is 2Vm, and for bridge circuit it is Vm. So this is the comparison of both half wave and full wave circuit. Okay, thank you.